Ender-3 by Creality 3D printer kit. This was shipped from the U.S. warehouse. Everything is well packaged. All the parts are in plastic bags. Extrusions are wrapped with protective plastic film. Basically a place for everything and everything in its place. Available spaces are filled up with foam or product. If the box is full, parts can't move around, you can expect it to show up in good condition. This was received in perfect condition. Very well packaged. This is a 3D printer kit. The largest assembly is this bottom section that has the Y-axis and the table, the motherboard, all of that is connected. The hot end is already wired in. The power supply. The first thing I do in a power supply is switch this to 115 volts for here in the States. The controller. These are extrusions for the power or the support for the Z-axis and what the X-axis transports across. A word of warning. This lead screw was inside this piece of rubber to protect it. And it was shoved up inside one of these extrusions. This was all wrapped with saran wrap. I picked that up and just accidentally saw it coming out here and caught it before it went to the floor. So you do want to be careful about that. You have a instruction sheet and it gives you list one and list two and then starts going through the steps. 1, 2, 3, 4 by the numbers. And shows you with the pictures how to put this together. First thing you want to do is go through all the parts, make sure that you have them. These all have labels on them as to what they are as far as metric size. And it goes through the larger components like the controller, the power supply, the carriage for the X-axis and the extruder. The motor for the Z-axis, the stepper for the Z-axis, bag of tools, the putty knife, the nippers, small roll of filament, and the mounting bracket for the filament. Your memory card. There's information preloaded on the card. And you can go to your computer and read some of those files about how to put this together and how to operate it. This is the micro switch for the end stop for the Z-axis. And this is the turnaround pulley for the X-axis belt. And the X-axis belt is right here. You can go to Thingiverse and look at all the things that people have come up with as modifications or improvements to this. I did the same thing when I got the CR10. And there's a lot of good information. People have gone to a lot of work to provide. One would be a cover over the end of this return pulley so that you don't get things caught in the pulley when this is going back and forth. This right here is not very good. That's the cooling fan for the motherboard and that. And it's wide open. And there are bits and pieces that will come off of this and go straight through that fan. So there's a number of different little pieces of ductwork that will use these two screws to hold it in place, and it gets the fan to take its air from this side or over here on the left. When you turn this over gently, all of these wires are coming out where this piece of extrusion has been milled away. They have not deburred this edge at all. So one of the first things I intend to print is a plastic piece that snaps in there to protect these wires from abrasion or being cut. Some of these have got a little rough edge on them already. Probably would never be a problem, but the engineer in me says that that needs to have a piece of plastic put in there. You want to go through this whole thing and check every nut and bolt for being tight. The easiest time to do the Y-axis is right now before you start putting it together. And I can feel that this has 1, 2, 3 little clunks. basically it's flat spots on these tires or these wheels. And that usually means that this is just a little bit too tight and it's been sitting in one position since it left the factory. It's like having your car parked outside on a cold day and you get flat spots on your tires. You can feel it, one, two, three. And there's three of them because that little wheel has to go around three times to get from this end to this end. So if you feel that, that carriage is just a bit too tight. The back of the controller has been left open. There are a couple of designs on Thingiverse for a box or cover that will go over this and completely enclose this so you don't somehow accidentally short this out with a piece of metal. And most of those attach with existing screws. This appears to be the exact same hot end that's on the CR10. And on that unit, I took this metal bracket off and printed what is called a fang cooler. And it directs the air more efficiently over the heat sink and gets the air down around the nozzle. I intend to do that or something similar to that on this one as well. My only criticism on this unit is that it came with the power cord with a European plug and not the US plug. But that's a quick fix. I have a few power cords left over from old computers. And they fit right in there. When you get ready to start putting this together, what they're showing here are these 20 by 40 aluminum extrusions, which are the vertical columns or towers. On the one for the left, they show two holes drilled in it, which are these two holes. And that goes here, and that's where your Z-axis stepper motor attaches. And on this one, they have these two holes, which are here and here. And that's what's drilled here and here. You then have the two 20 by 20 extrusions. And they show two holes on each end. That's this one. This is the one that goes across the top between these two. It goes across here. The other one, this is what your X-axis trolley goes back and forth on. And these are milled out here to clear the head of this bolt that goes through there. That goes on there like that. And you have to get your two bolts to come through these holes, and you can tighten them through here. And the hole on this side is so you can later reach in here and do your adjustments on this cam for adjusting that wheel so it will go up and down for the Z-axis. The other is just the opposite. This is your other bracket that goes on the right-hand side. That clears there, and you run your two bolts in through there. And they screw into the threads that are already tapped in this piece. And again, this hole gives you access to be able to adjust the tightness of this wheel using the cam. This has a good reputation for being a relatively new printer. You can buy this printer for less than $200. Reason being, it's a kit, and you have indicated that you're willing to do some of the assembly, and the manufacturer doesn't have to do that. And it's also easier for them to package this into a smaller box. It's always a good idea to take your fastener and see if it wants to go in there freely before you start assembling whatever it is you're working on. And make sure that there's no burrs or anything on there. You don't damage the thread. What they're trying to show you in the diagram with these little T-nuts properly installed, it should be horizontal across that channel. You can either slide it down or you can stick it in. As long as it's still loose, it'll turn. And properly installed, that should be horizontal across that channel. Any other orientation would be incorrect. For the Z-axis micro switch, if this little foot is resting on top of this channel, and this piece of plastic will be flush against this part. I like this fan cover. Looks like the front end of a Jeep. But I really think this is too restricting. This is the suction side of a fan, and you do not want to restrict airflow on the suction side of a fan. I printed another one. It has these supports. They continue all the way back to here, and again, this will end up being a restriction to the fan. So I'm going to cut all of this out of here, and it'll be wide open to the front. Took a wire cutter's net and snipped out the big pieces and broke it off with a pair of pliers. Then using the Fordham tool, went in there and ground that out, ground all of this out. So that's now wide open. That will not restrict airflow. Adjust the wheels on these two carriages before you put this crossbeam on. This hot end trolley has to go on here before this is attached to the beam. And you take the fan off so you can adjust this eccentric to adjust the tightness of these wheels. Make sure these two screws are tight and that this is at right angles to your bed. You can put a clamp on here to hold this up here so this doesn't go crashing down and hit your, maybe damage your bed. I'm going to use these clips. There's a gap right here that go over the black and red wire. This is your power supply connection here. The power supply is over here. Wire's coming down. I use a clip here and a clip on the other side. And the wires are coming from the motherboard. There's a clip here. Those wires are too long, so I just doubled them over. Then the wires from the Y stepper and the limit switch, put a zip tie around those. And I have another clip that will come up here and will hold these wires in position. Wire management is something that is going to have to be addressed on this, because when this comes back, if this wire gets over here somehow, it'll get caught behind this table. So we need to get this over here and control it so this can go up and down with the Z axis. And then this one, that table can go back and forth. All of these pieces for the cable chain print flat on the bed. No support. As these print, these edges are stair-stepped. You're going to have to clean that up. When sand that smooth along the edge, round them over. I use an emery board to smooth the surface. On the other end, I use an emery board to clean this up. Knock off edges and use an X-Acto blade to clean it up. I put a little bit of cooking oil on those pins. Put that together, make sure everything moves freely, wipe it off with a paper towel, and good to go. The person who contributed this cable chain on Thingiverse has done a very good job with this. Oh, this is a good design, and it keeps your cable lined up with the table as this goes back and forth. And this piece replaces what comes with the printer. You just take that off and take the zip tie off, snap this in place, put a new zip tie on it, and then it anchors down here on this 40 by 40 V-track. And then this one, its job is to make sure that this stays exactly lined up as this gantry goes up and down. These pieces just snap together. There's no glue or zip ties or anything on there. And they work very freely. As long as you keep this lined up and square, goes straight up and down with the Z-axis travel, you shouldn't have a problem. And as this goes up, I have this piece that's on the extruder that holds the hot end cable, and I have it bent at a 90 here and then retained with this zip tie to keep this lined up so this goes up and down with the gantry. The hot end cable and the wires that go to the extruder and the stepper and the limit switches, they follow a little bit different path. And I have this wire laying flat against the inside of these links. The hot end cable is on top of that. And when I get about three links back, I brought that out because these follow a slightly different path as they go up and down. The rear support for the power supply is available. Don't know that it's necessary, but it does plug up this gap here and gives it a bit of a streamlined appearance, and it's a perfect fit. I'm not sure if I mentioned earlier, but I printed a cover for the circuit board on the back of this controller. And then this is a cover for the end of the X-axis. Just keeps things from getting tangled up between that belt and the pulley. I've treated this a little bit different than the assembly instructions, which shows this being straight up and down. I turned this bracket around, which shoves this to the rear of the printer a little bit further, and that allows this filament to be more in line with where it has to go into the extruder. I've got an adapter bracket here that lays this over, gets the edge of the filament out here well past the machine. If the bracket was back here, the filament has to make an awful sharp bend to get down into the extruder, especially when this is down lower. With this sitting over here, then I've used this ball bearing filament guide. This pushes onto the extruder mounting bracket. You may have to take these four screws loose on this X-axis stepper and just allow that to go down a little bit and retighten it, and then this will push onto that bracket. This is a well-designed little bracket. With the filament out here and this ball bearing guide, that will have a nice even flow for the filament. This filament can be kind of brittle sometimes. You don't want it to get kinked trying to go through this extruder. And as this goes down, you can see that's still a nice even flow. That's on a spool that's just about empty. On a full spool, that'll come out here even better. It's easy to see on Thingiverse that people have been having problems with the alignment of the Z-axis stepper and the lead screw. They've been making shims in that to go back behind the stepper, and I do not believe that's the correct answer. The problem is up higher on the bracket that holds the lead screw nut. I've made a separate video covering that. The first print is a 20 millimeter test cube. The controller says the bed's running at 60 degrees. That's 59.3, 60.6, 61.7, 61.4, 61.2, 57.7, 58.8, 59.6, 60.3. That's pretty close when you consider there's no insulation on the bottom of that bed. And this black surface works well with the infrared thermometer. This is the first time this has been powered up, and after a few minutes it starts to smell like something's burning. That's the heating element and this covering on the bed and power supply and a lot of new electronics the first time that they're operating. That smell will go away after a while. It took 34 minutes to print that. Comes right off the bed. Make sure we're zeroed here. X is 20.09. Y is 20.15, Z is 20.17. I've got this set for ironing on the top. It really did give a smooth surface, but there's no bumps or anything on that. The bottom has a nice even texture. Of course, that's the same as the texture on the bed. Number of issues with this printer, number of strong points as well. This video is already too long to go into that in any detail. I will make a review video and tell you exactly what I think.